Is has the recording started?
Yes.
Okay. Good morning, class.
Yes, ma'am.
We were doing rural administration or district administration, and the head was the DM. That means district magistrate. And which other names do we have for him? District collector, or also he is called a
deputy commissioner.
Deputy commissioner. Yes, and now we talked about the various functions that he does. And first one was maintenance of law and order. And in that we know that the law and order is headed by, is looked after by the head person being the SP or SSP, superintendent of police, or he is also called senior superintendent of police. And he is an IPS officer, which is a good rank holder. He's a good rank holder, and it is also a competitive exam that after you qualify that exam that you get a chance to become one. Then we also talked of jailer and deputy jailer, who are the heads of the jail authority. That means any criminal with a criminal record is jailed, and then it is the jailer who looks after them. Okay. Then the second work we took was the land records and collection of revenue, which was undertaken by the head being the tehsildar. Okay, he is helped by Nayab Tehsildar, and then the person below him is known as Kanun Goes, and then the last at the village level, it is the Patwari who looks after. Then we now talked of the civic amenities. That means the various civic development areas, whatever we do as a development for the country, for the place, sorry, not country, the district, whatever we do at the district level, that is called amenities and development. When we were doing this, we talked about various officers who work after, like for education. Now, one thing we need here is education. Okay. And who looks after the education? Who looks after the education? Come on. District Education Officer. District Education.
Education Officer.
Very good. Now, in the field of medicine or medical, who looks after the health and medical? Is
that the district medical officer?
Yes, district medical officer. And now for the development of roads, etc. Roads and buildings.
Man, the executive engineer.
I'm the executive engineer.
Executive
engineer. Engineer.
Ma'am, PWD. Ma'am of PWD.
PWD. What is the full form of PWD? Public. Come on. Public Work Department. Now the next is, that is the last function we take up, is called, can you see? Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Superintendent of Panchayati Raj. Now, what is Punjabi Nath? Punjabi Nath is a village organization. Just as in the towns, we have municipal committee and municipal corporation. In the village level, we have Punjabi Nath to look after the village administration. So, it is the work of the district magistrate or the DM
to look after what is going on in the villages which come under his district. Okay, he keeps a check on the Panchayati Raj. I will read out. The district collector also has to keep an eye on the working of the three tiers of Panchayati Raj and the other local self-government institutions in the district. Elections of all these are held under his supervision. He can get their accounts audited. If he finds that a local self-government in the district is not working satisfactorily, he can recommend to the state government for its suspension and holding of fresh elections within 6 months of the suspension of a local body. The district collector is the hub around which the wheel of district administration moves. He is the core of our administrative system. So all we need to know is that in the supervision of the Panchayati Raj or the local bodies, not just Panchayati Raj, plus there are local bodies also under that. Which are the other local bodies? Municipality. Or what are the other? Municipal corporation. Remember, municipal corporations are for big towns and cities. Municipal committee is for a small municipality, is for a small area. Okay, so it looks after the Panchayati Raj plus the local bodies. Okay, there are different wards into which it is divided, and then the whole setup is looked after by DM. The district, we will today only take up this much. We will do the rest in our next class. I hope this much is clear to each one of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I'm trying to send this whole image to you.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Jain.
Ma'am, your recording is stopped in between when you were teaching us.
So Manvi has started the. This is something new and important, and we need to pay attention. Okay. So last time we did the rural administration or district administration, as it is also called, and in that we did the power and functions which are conducted by the district magistrate, the head of the district. We did all the various powers, and you all can see it is still written: maintenance of law and order, land records and collection of revenue.
Yes, ma'am.
Civic amenities, and then the last was supervision of Panchayati Raj. Okay, so all this is given, and I have told you also. Did you get it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today we begin with the last function, which is judicial administration. Now, judicial administration cannot be totally said that it is under district magistrate. Though he is the head, it is under him that the things are supervised. But then judiciary is always free.
Adapter.
Put your mic on.
Adapter.
Don't ask for a doctor by shouting. Switch off your mic and then ask for the doctor. Okay, so basically the judicial administration is very separate from all the other powers of the district magistrate. When we talk of judicial powers, we call them that judiciary is always fair, free. These are the two terms we use, free and fair. That means judiciary is free from any legislature and executive powers. That means the district magistrate has little control over them, though he can check them if they are wrong. But then he cannot guide them. Okay, you can punish him, you cannot punish him. This is not under him. Judiciary is always free and fair. Okay, so we call it a power of district magistrate, But then judicial administration is also taken and dealt separately. Okay, so we will read about them. Can you all see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, we can see.
Ma'am, recording.
Yes, ma'am. Not begin.
It has begun. Yeah,
ma'am, it has begun.
Ma'am, it has begun.
Bus. Judicial administration. Each district has a judicial setup for administration of justice. All kinds of disputes occur in a district. It can be a dispute between citizens or a dispute between the government and citizens. Those persons with criminal activities also need to be punished. Lawsuits are filed in courts. Then the civil courts and cases concerning the property. Whose mic is open? Cases concerning the properties and financial disputes fall under civil courts. And cases of theft, assault, murder, or other criminal acts are heard in criminal courts. So now we all know that at a district level, there's a judicial setup. Judicial setup means where you can go and ask for justice. Okay? Where justice is imparted, that is called the judicial. Okay? So now that could be a dispute between a citizen and another citizen. You fighting with your neighbor, or it could be a dispute between a government and the citizen. That means you have a problem with the government and you have filed a case against them. A common citizen filing a case against the working of the government. Then there are different lawsuits. That means there are different patterns. That means the broadly categorized patterns are the civil courts and the criminal courts. That means civil courts are those courts where you have a dispute of, say, land, say, your tenant or a landlord. So all these land disputes or money-related disputes, or you can say the causes which you pursue, all these disputes come under civil courts. Then criminal courts are those courts where you are basically dealing with criminals who have committed some crime, or they are into theft, murders, assaults, any other such thing that is categorized as a criminal case. Okay, so they are broadly divided into two, the civil and the criminal. Now, if you see here, I have made a chart for you. Judicial administration at the district level is managed in two forms, the civil cases and the criminal cases. Civil cases are pertaining to land and property. Criminal cases are pertaining to theft, assault, murder, etc. Then we will talk about these various judges. Let us first read about them. Officers and their working. Now, people who are in charge for judicial administration, they are the district judge and the additional district judge are in charge of the highest court for civil cases in the district. The subordinate civil judge, first class, sub-judge, second class, and munsif are subordinate to the court of the district judge. So see here, regarding the civil cases, the head is the district judge. Plus, he is assisted by additional district judge. In the absence of district judge, it is the additional district judge who takes charge. So these two are basically the head of the district judge in related to the matters of civil cases. Then under them is the subordinate civil judge, first class. Below him is sub-judge, second class. And then in the last is the munsif. So this is the chart for the civil judges, the order. Okay, here they have told you this only. Now they are telling you that the district judge, additional district judge, and the subordinate judge, first class. That means district judge, additional district judge and subordinate civil judge first class. These three, they have the power to hear suits without any limit relating to their value. Now, these three have the power to listen to the land cases or revenue cases with no restriction. It could be a big, huge property dispute or a simple piece of land dispute, from a small to a bigger one. They have no restriction. They can look and solve. Till here, these three have the power to solve any sorts of land disputes. Okay. In the case of subordinate lower courts, their power, additional district judge and the subordinate judge have the power to sue any limits. Okay. In the case of subordinate lower courts, their power is determined in accordance with the provision of the Suits Valuation Act and its rules. Now, when it comes to sub-judge second class and Munsif, if they are on the sitting on the seat and the court has to hear any case, then they are restricted in their powers. They cannot listen to big, huge property disputes. They don't have the power. Sub-judge second class and Munsif, the suits of valuation. That means if they are of high value, they can't be heard. So their evaluation is done. Their value is taken out that this property, the case which you have, which has come, has a big, huge property to deal with. So these two cannot deal with that. For that, these three are there: district judge, additional district judge, and subordinate civil judge, first class. Okay. Then we come on to the next. The court of session judge is the highest court in the district for criminal cases. Now see this, the criminal cases, that means theft, murder, dacoity, and any assault, all this is called criminal. And the criminal cases are dealt by the session judge. He is the head of the criminal cases, okay, in the district level. Serious criminal cases like murder and dacoity are heard by the court of the session judge or the additional session judge. Now, I forgot to write here, session judge plus additional session judge, SJ. Okay, said additional session judge. Just as we have district judge and additional district judge, here we have session judge, additional session judge. They both are the head. They look after the matter. The matters come under them. Any criminal matters I'm talking of. Now, the session judge can award death sentence, but the death sentence can be confirmed by the High Court. So now listen, these two, they have the power to even give a death sentence to a criminal, that the criminal should be sentenced to death. These two have the power, but at the same time, since they are in the district level, they have to take the consent of the highest court of a justice in that state, which is the High Court. Every state has a High Court. So they have to consult if they want to give anyone a death sentence. They have to consult High Court as well. They are working in a district. What is a district? Small towns and cities, big towns and cities, and subordinating villages are clubbed in together in a state, and they are called districts. Now, many districts, they form the state. So state has a High Court. So if any session judge or additional session judge has to give a sentence of death to a criminal, then they have to also ask the High Court judge. Okay, they have to get the permission from them. Only then they can give the death sentence. Though they have the power. Unke paas power hai ki wo death sentence de de. लेकिन एक बार उनसे कंसल्ट करना पड़ता है उनको एंड आफ्टर कंसल्टिंग यस दे कैन गिव अ डेथ सेंटेंस ठीक है नेक्स्ट द चीफ जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट कैन अवार्ड अ सेंटेंस अप टू 7 इयर्स ऑफ इंप्रिजनमेंट नाउ बिलो देम इज द चीफ जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट नाउ बिलो द सेशन जज एंड एडिशनल सेशन जज द नेक्स्ट पोस्ट इज ऑफ द चीफ जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट He can only give 7 years imprisonment. 7 साल की सजा दे सकता है इससे ज्यादा कुछ नहीं. Okay? then the chief judicial magistrate can award a then a first class magistrate can award a maximum sentence up to 3 years of imprisonment or a fine or both. Ab next unse niche jo hai first class magistrate, he can give 3 years imprisonment or a little bit of fine. Okay, okay. Then below him is the second class magistrate who can give 2 years of imprisonment and a little bit of fine or both. In this case also both. Okay, so fine or both. Then a second magistrate can award a maximum sentence up to 2 years of imprisonment or a fine or both. So these both have fine plus 3 years of imprisonment and 2 years of imprisonment. Can you see? I'll quickly revise. Session judge, additional session judge, they are the head. They can give death sentence in a criminal case. In the civil case, we don't give death sentence. Kisi ne mara nahi hai kisi ko. Kisi insaan ki death nahi ki hai usne. Criminals karte na, ek dusre ka khoon kharaba. So here the death sentence is given. And this is to be sanctioned by the High Court. Then below him is the chief judicial magistrate. He can give 7 years of imprisonment. Then first class magistrate, he can give 3 years of imprisonment and fine or both. Then below him is the second class magistrate. He can give the maximum punishment of 2 years of imprisonment or he can fine or he can do both. 2 saal ki saza bhi di aur kuch fine laga diya. 3 saal ki saza di aur kuch fine laga diya. Okay, so it is like that. Did you get it? Did you understand? Oh, thank you. Yes, thank you for the response.
Yes, ma'am.
I really appreciate that. Okay, so the amount of fine depends on the crime as well as the power of a judge. Now, the amount of fine, aap kitna paisa fine mein le rahe ho, that depends upon the position you are as a judge. Plus, कितना क्राइम किया है उतना ही तो फाइन लगाओगे. 2 साल की सजा हुई है तो उसमें उस हिसाब से फाइन लगेगा. 3 साल की सजा हुई है उसमें उस हिसाब से फाइन लगेगा. सो इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द वैल्यू ऑफ द फाइन. ओके, वैल्यू ऑफ द क्राइम डिपेंड्स ऑन द क्राइम एज वेल एज ऑन द पावर ऑफ द जज. किस जज के पास कितनी पावर है, कितने का वो फाइन ले सकता है. ओके, इफ समवन इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद द जजमेंट ऑफ अ लोअर कोर्ट, ही और शी कैन अपील अगेंस्ट द डिसीजन ऑफ द decision to the higher courts. The High Court is the highest judicial authority in a state and district courts function under it. As I told you, this district courts, they function under the High Court. So it is, supposing any person is not satisfied with the working of the district courts, call it civil, call it criminal, if they are not satisfied, they can always go to the highest court of justice. Sorry, the higher court of justice in the state, which is the high court. And supposing if they do not get justice over here also, then they can go to the highest court of justice, highest. And what is that? Highest court of justice, can you name it?
Ma'am, Supreme Court.
Ma'am, Supreme Court.
Supreme Court.
Supreme Court.
Supreme
Court.
Ma'am, Supreme Court.
Ma'am, Supreme Court.
Supreme Court कहाँ है? Delhi में, capital city.
From Delhi.
Delhi.
High Court of Justice. Supreme Court is one court which is dealing with all the courts in the country. Then High Courts, every state has a High Court. Every state has a High Court, and under the High Court there are many judicial administrations in the various districts. ठीक है? Did you understand this? With this, we come to an end of the chapter. Now, next time when we meet, we will be doing the question answers and exercises pertaining to the chapter. I hope the concept of this chapter is clear to each one of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.